Let us pray. Let's all stand up. Let's come before the presence of God. Hallelujah. Father, we come before your presence, God. You said to your word, if there's two or three gathered in your name, Lord God, you are in our midst. Thank you, Lord God. We confess to you, Lord, our sin, iniquities, and transgression, Lord. Wash us clean, Lord, with your precious blood, and may you purify us, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for giving us the opportunity to come before your presence, Lord God, to encounter you like never before, and to receive a revelation from you, Lord God. Holy Spirit, prepare our hearts. We worship you, Lord, in spirit and truth. Come on, let's pray in the spirit. We worship you, Lord God. Be lifted up, be magnified, be glorified, Lord God, in this place, Lord God. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord God. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We magnify your name, Lord God. You are good, Lord. Your love endures forever. Sheketa prapakanda de balabasinde de belebekenda de balabasaka. Shokota prapakanda. Come, Holy Spirit. We welcome you in this place. Sheketa prebekenda de balabasanda de belebekenda de balabakande. Let your anointing fill us, Lord God, and to those who are watching, Lord God, let them receive your touch, Lord God, as we worship you and as we seek you with all of our heart. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord Jesus. We magnify your name, Yahweh. We worship you. You are powerful. You are awesome. You are mighty. You are El Shaddai. Surround this place with your glory. Surround this place with the wall of fire. Surround your people, Lord God, with your presence, Lord God, with your mighty protection. Sheketa prapakatale yadamakande, lire probosokoyo. Sheketa prapakika, seketa prabasanda. Lord, we position ourselves, Lord God, to receive everything you have for us for today, because this is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Seketa probokonda dalabalabashiketa yadamakaya. Lere bambamba shkana mandeya. Lire prebeketo sukota prabashande. Let your presence flow, Lord God. Let your presence touch everyone, every heart. Fill us, Lord God, with your mighty, fresh anointing, Lord God. Let's get the prebeketa dalabalabakunde dalabalabakika. Sere probosokota palabashande. Shikera prabakataya. Lerembra basiketa prapakanda, sukote pesinda de la balabakika, lera provocota leyena masante de la balabashinde de la balabakanda de la balabakuto, serembra bashanda de la belebekanda. We bless you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. We worship you and we honor you. We love you, Lord Jesus. Come on, clap your hands, all your people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Hallelujah.
Lord, come on, let's give the Lord another clap offering. He deserves all the praise. Yes, Lord, we worship you. We praise your name. We worship you, God. You're a good Father, Lord. Lord, we come here with open hearts, Father God. We want to meet you today, Father God. We want to experience you today like never before. We worship you, Lord. Start to clap our hands and let's praise his name. Yeah, yeah. worship you, God. Lord, you deserve all the praise.
Amazing grace. This is a great. conquer the grave.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Come on.
Worthy is the King who conquered.
Sing it. Worthy. Worthy is the Lamb
who was slain.
You are worthy.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave.
You are worthy.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Come on, church, one more time. With power now. Oh, you are worthy. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
One more time, you are worthy, God.
Worthy is the King.
Louder, sing it out, worthy. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. You are worthy.
Worthy is the King who conquered.
Help comes from you, oh God. God, we just praise your name. We just praise your name. We just want to be thankful right now. We're just thankful for what you have done for us. For sending your son, Jesus Christ, to shed his blood on the cross. Oh, Lord, the blood, the blood. very last time. I love you, Lord.
And I love you.
Yes, God.
And I lift my heart to
come on.
Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense.
Come on.
Day and night, night and day, let
Sira.
Revelation chapter 4. Book of Revelation chapter 4, verse 12, it says, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, He is worthy of all worship and praise because He was slain as a sacrifice to replace us of our due punishment. For the wages of sin is death, but He died in our place. Amen. He died in our place. This is why we worship Him today. We praise Him. We glorify Him. This is why we are able to come into the presence of the Father, into the throne room, in the throne room of God. In 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18 to the 19th verse, it says, knowing that you were not redeemed with corruptible things like silver or gold from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as a lamb without blemish, without spot. The blood of God Himself, the second person of the Trinity, the precious blood of God, was shed for you and me. Amen. This is why today we are able to come and worship the Lord in the most holy place. Hallelujah. That's why we have the boldness to come. Because we have been purchased by the precious blood of God. Amen. Today, we take communion in remembrance of what Jesus Christ has done on that cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago. Amen. Raise up the bread, even at your homes. The bread, a symbol of the body of Jesus Christ, broken for you, beaten up for you, slain, the Lamb who was slain for all of us, that we may have eternal life. Come and remember His mercy and grace. Come and partake and remember His mercy. The wine, symbolic of the precious blood of Jesus Christ, shed for you and me to wash us clean of every sin, every transgression. Amen. Come and remember His goodness. Hallelujah. For your blood washed us clean, white as snow. Thank you for your sacrifice, oh God. On the cross of Calvary, that we may have eternal life. Oh, glory, honor, power, dominion belongs to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today, let's continue to worship the Lord with our giving. Amen. My favorite scripture about giving, because giving is worship, in Hebrews chapter 7 verse 8 says, here on earth mortal men receive the tithes and the offerings, but there in heaven he receives it. Amen. This is a testimony that he lives. This is a wonderful scripture that tells us the tithes and the offerings, we return the tithes to the Lord because it belongs to him. It is worship. Only worship belongs to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. But today I would like to read to you Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verses 1 and 2 says, cast your bread upon the waters, for you will find it after many days. Give a serving to 7 and also to 8, for you do not know what evil will be on the earth. What is this? The bread is symbolic of our substance. Amen. What we have. When I was young, in the 70s, we used to call money bread. This was in the 70s. But today, bread, I would say, is very much a symbol of our substance. So it says, when you cast your bread, when you sow your seed, your financial seed, again, it is worship. Amen? And I want us to go to verse 4. He says, he who observes the wind will not sow, and he who regards the clouds will not reap. What is this? If we do not sow and we do not reap, it means if we will not sow, we will not reap. Hello? Because it's a principle. Yes, we give our tithes and offerings as worship, but there is a principle that operates in the heavenlies, the principle of sowing and reaping. And it says in verse 5, as you do not know what it is the way of the wind, or how the bones grow in the womb, or of her who is with child, so you do not know the works of God who makes everything. What does it mean? It means it is the Lord who decides whatever we sow, he will make it work for his glory. Amen. In verse 6, in the morning sow your seed, in the evening do not withhold your hand, for you do not know which will prosper, either this or that, or whatever, both alike will be good. So whatever we sow, I believe if we sow it with the right motives, in accordance to the word of God, as worship, we will reap because we have sown. Because it's a principle in the word of God, in the Old Testament and in the New Testament alike. Amen. When we sow, we will reap, because this is worship and obedience to the word of God. Amen. So right now, let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord with our giving. Hallelujah. Lord, we raise up the offering to you today. Receive it up in heaven as we receive it here on the earth today, as a testimony that you are alive, because this is our worship. Use it for the furtherance of your kingdom and return it 100-fold to your people. In Jesus' name, amen. As you see on the screen, we have online giving. Just give with our online giving. This is our worship today. Amen. Pastor Mark.
Good afternoon, everyone. To our viewers in your respective homes, praise the Lord for the technology we can have. We can go on with our worship. Amen. Even though we have our quarantine. So welcome to the online church, online worship of River of God. And before we proceed to our word for today, we'll just have a few announcements. So for your online giving for the tithes and the offerings, we would like to give you this account wherein you can where you can give and transfer your tithes and your offerings. You can continue to worship the Lord through your giving by doing it online. Again, you can transfer or deposit your tithes and offerings at the River of God Inc. account. That is in China Banking Corporation. Our account number is 12219-0071-3. And if you have made a deposit or transfer, please make sure to scan or take a photo of your deposit slip or money transfer confirmation, and please send it to the River of God Galleria inbox. Again, River of God has launched a donation drive. It's called Blessed to be a Blessing. This is our way in fighting the COVID-19 again to our giving. We will be giving priority to those, to our members who are from all River of God churches, who are low-income earners and have no earnings this period of quarantine. So if the Lord is touching your heart to be a blessing to these people, please channel in your donations again at the same account. Just make sure to send your deposit slips or money transfer slips to our Facebook account. Again, also, since we have the quarantine today and we cannot go out of our own houses to meet with our life groups, you can utilize the social media platforms for our online discipleships. So we have all social media platforms that you can make use. We have, the popular one now is Zoom, but you can also do use Skype and Messenger, WeChat, WhatsApp, and even Viber. All right, so take note also for life group leaders, you have launched a group chat where you can update us with what's going on with your discipleships. And for this week, we will be making an outline from the preaching of Pastor Rachel, and we can use this for our own discipleships. You know, we can study about the timely messages of the Lord for us. Amen. And also, if you need prayer and counseling, you can send your prayer requests to our Facebook page inbox, and you can leave your prayer requests there. You can also state whether you want to be prayed for personally by our pastors, and we can assign our pastors and leaders to personally pray for you either through voice call or video calls. Amen? And by the way, just going back to our online discipleships, if you're a discipler and you're doing your discipleship online, you can take a photo of your life group and please put the hashtag ROG online discipleship so that we can monitor you. And if you have more questions or queries about what to do in your online discipleships, please feel free to post them at the group chat of the River of God life group leaders. Amen? So that is all for our announcements for today. Let us proceed with the Word of God. May I call on Pastor Rachel Sanchez.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. All right. Wow. You know how many times I always prepare sermons, but in the last minute, you know that God will tell you not to use that. So anyway, The Lord spoke to me and says we have to remember the prophecies He gave to us. And so I'm going to, this is remembering the 2018 and the 2019 prophecies that the Lord gave us. Father, we just praise You and we thank You, Holy Spirit. Take away every clutter in our hearts, in our minds. And we ask You, Lord, to speak to us through Your message. Help us, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now tell your neighbor, I know you can see me, and tell your neighbor, I don't see you. If you have a neighbor next to you, say, you are blessed. Amen. You are blessed. Hallelujah. On November 5, 2017, okay, 3 years ago, almost 2.5 years ago, while I was doing my devotion, and many of you have heard this, the Holy Spirit spoke to me, and He wanted me to tell His church about His plans for 2018 and onwards, and we are now here in 2020. He gave me several revelations to tell His church, and I did that. I shared it in 2018 and 2019 to the River of God churches and to the affiliates, and I even used this in our May 28 and 29, 2018 speaking in the Activate 5 conference. And every engagements I had locally and internationally, I gave away also this revelation. And many of you have heard this, but God wants me to review and all of us to evaluate this prophecy so that we will know, in light of the present situation, if this is happening, being fulfilled, or to be fulfilled right before our very eyes. Now, the Holy Spirit said in 2017, and I will repeat this again, this is His exact words, my season is coming. 2018 is my season. He said this twice, and you know when the Holy Spirit speaks and when the Lord God speaks or say it twice, it means, hello, pay attention. This is very important. Prepare the people. The year 2018 is the beginning of revivals and revivals of hearts. I, that's the Holy Spirit, will awaken the virgins before the Master comes. 2018 is the start of the awakening and reviving of cold hearts. It's referring to the believers, okay? I will ignite the fire of revival again. Many will hear of me and see waves of glory. Many will be hungry for more of God. 2018 is my season. So I used this, I said this, and the Holy Spirit instructed me to read the book of Joel. And He directed me to Joel 2, 28 to 29. Let me just read it. And afterward, so I don't know after what. Maybe after what's happening right now, testing and trials. I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. Even on my servant, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. The Holy Spirit, as we know, has been given to us thousands of years ago. But the revelations to many children of God today is that there's going to be a mighty move of God, an outpouring, a flooding of His divine presence. His glory will be seen, and the power of God is going to flood, and nothing can stop or hinder this flooding of the presence of God. In other words, in Tagalog, babaha ng presensya ng Panginoon. Amen? And no one, nothing, and no one for any reason, not even the virus that's going around the world, can stop this. Walang makapipigil dito. Saints, I want you to believe this, and I want you to see, and I believe we have not seen this divine outpouring of the Holy Spirit. It is also said in Acts 2, verses 17 to 18. We are probably experiencing sprinkles. Ambun lang ang ating na-i-experience. We have a worldwide charismatic revival or renewal in the past, and many churches were brought together by this revival, and love was experienced. There was unity. But I believe it is just a foretaste, a foretaste. Presently, I'm hearing that many churches are welcoming the supernatural move, the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Now we're in 2020, and I'm so excited with what God is going to do. Amen. I hope you are excited. Now, going back to my teaching, In the beginning of 2018, there were three things I explained in that sermon. So you, if you want to hear that, go back in the January of 2018. There were three things I explained based on the revelation of the Holy Spirit. They were preparation, awakening, and revival. I explained that fully those times. And the whole world now knows that we have a pandemic. It's worldwide. Why? Due to the virus, the COVID-19, infecting millions and killing thousands of people. The virus halted the normalcy of life. It has created something. It affected economies of different nations. It created fear and anxiety amongst people, even the believers. Look around you. There are many gatherings, conferences, and events that were canceled. Travels were canceled, banned. Public socializing, you know, are prohibited. Even church services and gatherings are prohibited, etc., etc. The day-to-day operation of the whole world has been hindered by this demonic plague. And there is the spirit of fear affecting the nations. In January 2020, this year, when I heard of the virus, I prayed. And I asked the Lord, what is this virus? And he simply said, man-made. Man-made. That's all what the Lord said. I did not ask for any details. I didn't ask why. I did not ask what it is. All I understood in my spirit, I receive it that there is a demonic spirit behind this contagion. And, you know, that's all I know. We have this demonic spirits behind this virus. And these demonic spirits are carrying this virus. It is transferred from one person to another. It's just jumping and leaping all over people. It's just like those days in the Bible when the sons of Sheba, or Sceva, I think how you pronounce it, when the demons, you know, leaped to the people because they were not really walking righteously before God. Ephesians 6:12 says, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age." Rulers of darkness. We're talking about demonic. Against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. People hearing me now, you may think I'm crazy and I keep talking about this is demonic and I don't care, but I want you to hear and listen. If you're a child of God, no matter if you love Jesus and Jesus is living inside your heart, the blood of Jesus is your barrier. He is a shield and no weapon of the enemy will touch you. And I say this to you, nothing can touch you nor harm you. Nothing. And so I want you to stand on the truth. No weapons of the enemy will prosper against you. Currently, Satan is making everyone fearful. He's making everyone anxious, being intimidated by this virus. People are panicking. People are scared, being locked down, not only in the Philippines, being quarantined in America. They're panicking. They don't know. You know, this is the scheme of the evil one. He wants to create chaos. He wants to create panic and confusion and fear. People are being greedy. This is also his scheme, the wiles of the evil one. They are hoarding goods. They are hoarding groceries. They are hoarding medicines. And they are being selfish in times of crisis. These people are captives. They are captives by the spirit of fear. And I said this last 2 weeks ago. And Satan is spreading this fear worldwide. Even believers are falling into this trap. I have received messages and they said they are tormented. They are confused. Come on. You are children of God. You know, Satan is stealing your peace and your joy. He is trying to deceive you because he knows when you understand that you are more powerful from more than him. Oh my goodness. He will flee. You know, Satan is magnifying this pandemic. He is doing this. Church, I want you to magnify Jesus. This is is your golden opportunity. This is your glorious time to magnify Jesus, the healing power of Jesus, the delivering power of God. This is our season. It's time to arise. It's time to speak up and not to be cowards and just hiding in our rooms. When you listen to the news, you will be shocked. 2 weeks ago, when I was on this pulpit, the same pulpit, let me just read my notes. There was 282,700 confirmed infected worldwide. But today, as of yesterday at 4 o'clock, 1,140,641 people confirmed with coronavirus. That's a big leap, a big jump. 2 weeks ago, there was 11,800 deaths. Today, 61,189 deaths. Grabe! In our nation, currently we have 3,094 confirmed cases and 144 deaths. Church, we know this pestilence is a plague. It's written in the Word of God. And we also know that these are one of the signs of the end of days. Why? Jesus is returning soon. Going back to 2018 when the Holy Spirit says prepare. Why prepare? Why do you think the Holy Spirit gave me the word prepare? Prepare the people, he said. Prepare because something is going to happen. Imagine this, prepare the people. And I'm going to say some negative things and positive things in line with the current events. When the coronavirus was detected in December 2019 in Wuhan, China, since then, it was an epidemic at the time. Many, you know, had a virus. And when that time, in 2019, that was just an epidemic. And now, it's global. It's pandemic. Pandemic. Nations are in lockdown. People are in quarantine. We were all caught unaware of the magnitude of the spread of this virus. And we didn't know how contagious it is. The Holy Spirit said, prepare the people. Yet, up to now, we are not prepared. When I heard those words, I thought the Holy Spirit was referring to spiritual matters. We did our part. We prepared. We intensified our discipleship. We did our trainings in the prophetic. We did evangelism. We extended our, you know, expanded our reach. But we are still not prepared. In the physical, we are not prepared for crisis and calamities like this. Many countries were not prepared, not only the Philippines. Materially, there is a shortage of gears, protective gears, and needed stuff for the sick. There's a shortage of staff, workers, doctors, and nurses. There are shortages when it comes to facilities and hospitals. People are not prepared. We are not prepared. Yet the Holy Spirit says, prepare the people. I repented because I did not understand this. Companies, factories, restaurants, stores, malls, and homes are all locked down and in quarantine. People are not able to go to work. No work, no pay, no wages. Without money and no savings, you cannot buy food. We are not prepared. And even those who have money, they were not prepared because they're panicking, buying groceries. Not only this virus is pandemic, also, the fear Satan has created is pandemic. I thought it's only the virus, but the fear is worldwide. Pandemic. You know, saints, on a positive note, I know I've seen that negativism, I've shared that, and there are many more. But on a positive note, God has told his church. He gave us many warnings ahead of time, warnings and warnings through the Word of God if we're reading the Scriptures and meditating it, and through anointed servants of God. In the Scriptures, we were warned. We kept you know, preaching about this in Matthew 24, Matthew 25, Daniel 9, Luke 17, etc., etc. Read the Word of God. We were warned. So many. Yet, we are not prepared. As believers, let me tell you this. We are people of faith and not people of fear. Amen? Fear and unbelief are the absence of faith. If you have fear, it's the absence of faith. 2 Timothy 1 verse 7 says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." This is what God gave us. For God has not given us the spirit of fear. If you have fear right now, it's not God who gave that to you. It's the enemy. It's him. I'm sorry, but I believe these words. If you don't believe it, you do not really know God. That's why you have fear. Sorry, I'm telling you the truth. If you are walking in fear right now, you do not know God. I have to say it. I have to tell you this, saints, church, because as believers, we have the anointing. We have the authority and the power in Christ Jesus. I rebuke that fear right now in Jesus' name. You should not be intimidated by this virus. No way. Some, you know, I've received messages, I told you, and I sense right now in my spirit that some of us who are listening right now are tormented. Some of us are depressed. Oh, I rebuke that. The Word of God we just read, it says, sound mind. A disciplined mind. A mind that is not double-minded. Hello. Oh, wow. Believe the Word of God. Read it and meditate the Word because it is life. 1 John 4, verse 18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. Hallelujah. Because fear involves torment. That's what the enemy is doing. But he who fears has not been made perfect in love. Sorry, that's the Word of God. If you have fear, then it says here, he who fears has not been made perfect in love. You need to understand that God loves you so much that he doesn't want you to be afraid of anything. He doesn't want you to be afraid of any situation. He doesn't want you to be afraid of even this virus. Come on. The Word of God says fear, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. Amen. Fear God and fear not this virus. Saints, listen to me. Greater is he who lives in you than this virus. This enemy is already under your feet. And Satan doesn't want you to understand this. This is the mystery because he wants you to be imprisoned in this doubts, in this fear, in these things of the enemy. Don't. You are greater than this virus. Amen. Be encouraged. I remember Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul, when you read, you know, his letters to Timothy, his son, he encouraged Timothy while in prison. Imagine, he wrote letters while in prison. Similarly, we are in prison in our own homes. And that's the sad truth. We are quarantined inside our houses. And you who are listening right now, I'm encouraging you right now, get up and rejoice and dance with joy. Lift up your hands to the Lord and worship the King of Kings. This is the season. Saints, I want you to understand, this is the season to rejoice. And I want you to react. To react in your most holy faith. This is the season. Amen. Not to be fearful, but to intensify your faith, your trust in God, the promises of God in His Word. Amen. The Word of God says faith comes by hearing the Word. Hello? And hearing by the Word of God. Romans 10:17. It's so important we have to listen to the Word of God. And I thank God that you are being encouraged right now. I know there's a stirring in your spirit right now. And you are hearing the Word of God. Let every word that is planted in you right now grow in Jesus' name. Another positive thing that, you know, while we are in quarantine, and this is one good thing we can do, this is the season to go deeper in your relationship with God. Deeper every day. Put God as your priority. Worship Him in spirit and in truth. And talk to Him and pray unceasingly. Oh, I have many testimonies while worshiping God and while God is doing the battle for me. But I don't have time. But this kind of thing, easy. If God can move mountains, God can fight the battles, you know, for you. Oh, if God can make the sun, stand still. What is this virus? Nothing, nothing, nothing. Oh, hallelujah. You know, and while you're getting deeper in your relationship with God, I want you to take this opportunity to introduce your loved ones, the lost ones, those who do not know God, your family members, the unsaved one. Call your friend. It's time to start a family altar. It's time to do Bible studies. Hallelujah. Online, praise the Lord. Take advantage of the social media. It's one channel that God is using now for evangelization. Use it. Take advantage of it. Discipleship online. This is a must. Even though we're at home, it doesn't mean that you have to stop. Nothing can stop you but you yourself only. No one can stop you. If you allow the enemy to stop you, then you do not know your God. You should be sensitive. You should know that this is part of the preparation God is talking about before He returns. I'm also believing that as you are hearing this, and in the 2 years that have passed, I also believe that this is the season while we're intensifying our relationship with God. This is the season that the Holy Spirit will raise up spirit-filled, prophetic community of believers. They will be spirit-filled. They will encounter the Holy Spirit in their rooms, in their prayers, in their worship. Why? Because God is raising up a standard. These spirit-filled believers will teach, will impart, will encourage and empower His church so that all of us can do. You know what? The great awakening is coming. We can do and move mountains. We can move in the supernatural. I don't like to say this, but we are being warned right now to stop. But that is the truth. Because many hindrances are all in line to stop the move of God. The enemy wants to stop his church, God's church. But I want you to believe this. This is the season that we will be rising up. Amen. The Holy Spirit. You know, we read this in the Word. There are wars, rumors of wars, pestilences, plagues, you know. All these are coming. But if you believe in the supernatural work of the Holy Spirit, let me tell you, use your spiritual gifts. God has given you this so that the church will be able to do the Great Commission. Amen? And you will be able to do this powerfully. And discipleship. You will disciple the nations quickly and untiringly. No burnout, because the Holy Spirit will empower you. Amen? And this is really good. I love this. You know, we are all, and I know you're hearing me right now, all of us are in our homes or somewhere, but we are all strategically positioned. You know, different time zones, different places, different locations, wherever you are. But I believe this is very strategic because the Holy Spirit wants us to move in power and to spread the good news of salvation. Also, sometime in 2019, and you can just go back to our preaching in our FB account, the Holy Spirit gave me the word, the year 2019 is the year of empowerment and equipping. And we are doing this. So nothing should stop us, even online. We can do this. We can empower the brethren. We can really disciple So whatever the enemy is doing right now, hindering us, move in the opposite spirit. Do not allow him to give you torment. Do not allow him to just oppress you. When you move in the opposite spirit, when he stops you, you move forward. No gloom, no spirit of fear. Move in the opposite spirit. Just rejoice and have the time of refreshing, the best time of your life. Hallelujah. Also, I believe that while we are in quarantine, this is the season that the Spirit of God will fill us, overflowing to the brim, and believers will now, the Spirit-filled one, will be manifesting signs and wonders and miracles. Every word that we say online or tell people, we will manifest signs and wonders and miracles because that's his promise. He will complete the word. He will complete every message with signs, wonders following. And so believe that. I know if there are people hearing me, some of us will not understand this or they may contradict this. It's not easy to be accepted, you know, this kind of teaching that we... But I believe the Holy Spirit is creating a standard. A standard in these last days, because I believe he's preparing a bride with no wrinkles, no spot, a holy bride, because the bridegroom is coming. And I thank God that we here in River of God, our church, I'm not saying we're the best or what, I'm saying that we obey the Holy Spirit. We're teaching the prophetic workshops, supernatural ministry. We have been equipping people, the body of Christ, for many years. And I believe we have done our part. So right now, River of God, I'm sharing this to you. And if you're listening, whatever spiritual gifts you have, the God-given gifts that you have right now, use it against this demonic virus. It's demonic. Believe me, it's demonic. The word of God says, rebuke it and it will flee. Amen. So rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Resist it and do not allow the enemy to touch you. I also say something about, you know, I know, my time is so limited because we will still pray after this. But the Lord says that we have to prepare the people. And I believe that. I don't have time to explain it, but if you have time to review it in Luke 1, verses 13 to 17, when the angel spoke to Zacharias, that John the Baptist, the forerunner, and I believe that many of us will be forerunners right now, and many of us will prepare the people, unbelievers and believers alike, for the return of Jesus Christ. Another thing that I said was awaken the virgins. That's what the word of the Lord says. The virgins, the church of God. And Matthew 25, 1 to 13, that's your assignment. Read it very well. Meditate on it. And as you know, this speaks about the five foolish and the five wise. 10 virgins. Number 10 means testing and trials. I really want to explain this, but the Lord said to me, not yet. I explained this in some of my old sermons, but I realized number 10, and I say this all the time, means tests and trials. We are in the last days that the Lord will test his church. And five were wise. Five actually means service or servants, serving God. So there were five wise servants. In these last days, we need to be wise, to be real servants of God. You know, in this parable, Matthew 25, Jesus talks about the necessity of being prepared. And that's what the Holy Spirit is saying. Be prepared. And this parable talks about there are believers when Jesus returns who cannot join or who cannot enter because that of that joyful wedding, because they are unprepared. And we're talking about believers. Unprepared believers cannot participate in the joyful wedding of the Lamb. I'm sorry, but this is the truth. You ask your neighbor next to you, are you prepared? Are you prepared? This is what the Holy Spirit gave me. Prepare the people, awaken the virgins, the church, okay? Awaken? Why awaken? Because the church is sleeping. Natutulog ang iglesia. Tell your neighbor, gising, wake up. This is a wake-up call to the church of Jesus Christ. You know, and if you're listening right now, if you're a pastor, I am challenging you to check, evaluate the present condition of your church. I'm not saying River of God is perfect. No, I'm not saying that. What I'm trying to say here is we in River of God, we allow the Holy Spirit to move. We allow Him to rebuke us. We allow Him to lead us. We allow Him to prophesy. He guides us. And this is very important because the Lord Jesus is the Lord of every services. Amen. Equipping and empowering was the message of the Lord for 2019. And it's happening until now. And let me tell you, even if I'm trying to evaluate or we're reviewing the prophecies of 2018 and 2019 and up to now, I just want you to know it doesn't mean that that's not happening. It's happening. Whatever was prophesied in the past, it's still existing. Ephesians 2:8-10, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. For we are His workmanship, we are handiworks of God, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. You know, you should be prepared right now. We are God's workmanship, His own creation. Created in Christ Jesus. Church, we have been born again. We are spiritually renewed, transformed. And our goal is to be Christ-like. And we have to be using this opportunity for good works. Because this is what it is. This is the season. This is the season to walk and create good works for the kingdom. Serve the living God. Amen? Amen. And I want you to understand, how do you prepare yourselves? It says we have to prepare ourselves to help other people as well, to do something, to prepare in advance the body of Christ. And this is the call for the body, so that the body may be built up. That's in Ephesians 4:12. We prepare ourselves for good works by making sure that we are walking righteously, that standing right before God, and that our lives are clean. We prepare ourselves by walking in the Spirit every day, obeying the Word of God, applying it in our lives. That's preparation. In discipleship, we need to emphasize the importance of experiencing God, encountering God personally to all our disciples. We need to deepen our relationship with the Holy Spirit because He is the only one that can empower us in these last days. We need to know Him so that we will be able to, you know, to reach out to the lost and make more disciples in Jesus' name. Without the Holy Spirit, I do not know how we could continue, how we could exist. Holy Spirit is the one who makes signs and wonders and miracles. We need the Holy Spirit now to heal the sick and to pray for the frontliners and even for our government leaders. We need Him. He gives us strategies. Thank God for the strategy He gave last week about the gift of God evangelism cards and the tracts that we have. I've seen gears with, you know, with verses, Bible verses. Thank God for that. But I really want you to put the salvation prayer that anyone who receives it will really pray it from their heart. And I pray for them to be saved. When we read, you know, when we read the word, the parable of the 10 virgins, there is a word there. It says, and they started to trim their lights. To trim means to arrange, to beautify, to embellish, to put in order. And we just heard that in the song, in our worship earlier, that God is not a God of disorder. He is a God of order. And we need to do it now. We need to prepare. We need to be awakened. We need to be revived. And the 10 virgins, a parable, this parable speaks of revival before the second coming of Christ. Saints, I want you to understand the virgins are children of God. This message is for you, for every believer. It's the virgins are the holy ones who are separated in these last days. This is a wake-up call to all children of God, because the truth is some believers will not be part of this wedding. And I thank God that you're hearing this. Tell your neighbor, I hope you will be part of this great wedding. Keep watching. Keep watching. The time is near. Watchfulness does not mean idleness. While we are in quarantine, being watchful is a faithful discharge of responsibilities given to us by God. Take good care of your time. Use the spiritual gifts God gave you. Use the spiritual gifts that He has given you for such a time as this. Use the finances. Use the time. Use the resources God has entrusted to you so that we could advance His kingdom. This is the season. Thank God for the Holy Spirit, because He is our teacher. And He will guide us to the right path. At present, I want you to just be observant. Listen to the news. But do not be alarmed. Just watch around you. We know people are sick. And we are not allowed to come near them. We're not even allowed to lay hands over them. We're not even allowed to anoint them with oil. Not get near them. Why? Why is this happening? Because Satan does not like us to lay hands on sick people, because he knows they will get healed. He knows that in our hands there is power that will come out. The fire of the Holy Spirit will quench every viruses. He is afraid. You know what my cry is? And this makes me cry every day. I miss church. I miss the hugs and the kisses of you, my disciples. It just reminds me of Rachel crying out. There's a phrase or a verse crying out for her children. I miss that. That's the only thing I miss right now. I miss all of you. And Satan, he wants us to be locked down and not to go out. He doesn't want us to go to the hospitals. He doesn't want us to visit friends and heal people. Oh, and I feel the same thing, and I can sense God's love for everyone. James 5, 14 to 18 says, is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church. And let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And this is what Satan is using against us. And the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. Confess your trespasses to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, and he prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and it did not rain on the land for 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and heaven gave rain, and the earth produced its fruit. What I'm trying to say is keep praying, saints. Church, we need to pray. We need to do 2 Chronicles 7:14. We need to humble ourselves before God so that the Lord will heal us, forgive us. He will hear our prayers and forgive us. And I want all, and after this we will pray on behalf of our nation, to stand on behalf of every people, for every Filipino. And we should never stop praying. You know what the good news is? in 2 Corinthians 10, verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds. Prayer done in faith is powerful. We gotta put our faith, and it can demolish every strongholds. And there is power in our tongue. And I want you to take that. Put up the shield of faith. And use the word of God, the double-edged sword of the Spirit of God. Use it. The enemy will flee. And anything will declare. If we say that these demonic strongholds and fortresses that the demons have put up, it will crumble in the name of Jesus. I want you to fight. I want you to contend. I want you not to be deceived. I want you to stand against the wiles of the evil one. And you know what will be the result of all this? Revival. Revival. The sick will be healed spiritually. The sick, the physical sickness, everything. Anyone who's sick spiritually, physical, and emotional. All will be healed in the name of Jesus. Jesus paid for it. And I want you to always look at the cross. Revival means awakening. It is active. It is alive. And that's what revival means. You know, when I hear head of nations, like a president of a nation, will ask his countrymen to pray to God to stop this virus, to pray for the frontliners, to pray for the government. Wow, that is revival. Amen. That is revival. Imagine the head of nations asking, we need to pray. When parents and children are bonding at home, praying together, building the altar and praying to the Father, that's revival. When believers are reaching out to lost friends, to family members, when they are reconciling, when they're studying the Word of God, even online, that's revival. When people of God, when even those who do not know Jesus are worshiping God, rekindling the passion, going back to their first love, and listening to faith-filled teaching, that's revival. Amen. The Holy Spirit says to me, I will ignite the fire of revival again. And it's going to happen. Many will hear of Him, and many will feel it. Waves of glory will come upon the people of God. The Shekinah glory will be felt again. And this is coming. I believe this. And it's only Him who can do this, who can revive all of us. It has to start in the church. We need to be contagious, church. This virus is defeated. This virus is defeated. And God will not allow, He will not permit anything, any virus to hinder His plans. Amen? He will, and He will move. You cannot stop God. The enemy knows this. That's why he's putting discouragement. He knows that there will be a great outpouring of the Holy Spirit, and he's stopping everything. He's stopping everything, but it is a prophecy. And Romans 8:28 says, and we know that all things work together for good of those who love God, those who are called according to His purpose. You are the called one. It's time to arise. What the enemy meant for evil, God will turn it around for good. It's our season. Satan cannot outsmart God. Satan cannot stop God. Why? Because our God, Jehovah El Shaddai, is the Almighty God. He is all-knowing. He's omnipotent. He is ever-present God. I am not afraid because He's with me. And I thank God that He speaks. Our God is an all-powerful God, an ever-present God. He knows every scheme, so He has an answer to everything. He has the solution to every problem. Oh, I want you guys to be happy and rejoice that you are serving the one true God. I'm about to close, but I want you to know, even if we are inundated with this satanic or this plague or this virus, the Holy Spirit will raise up a standard. And the standards are the new breed of Holy Spirit-filled individual, and it better be you. We are in the last days. And God is creating people and stirring people, people who are undefiled, people who are not moving in darkness but carrying the light of Jesus Christ, people who will be the light in the midst of this perverse generation. You are the light in this darkness because you carry the one true light inside you. The Holy Spirit is preparing a bride, and He is coming soon. And the Holy Spirit is the only one who can make anything that is dead to be alive. It's the season. The Holy Spirit, whatever disease, He can heal. He can heal. And anything that is dead, He can make it alive. Even cold hearts. Saints, I want you to be encouraged. My time is finished, but I'm sure I'm going to see you again. And I hope to encourage you again. But before we close, I want you all to stand up, and I want you to pray along with me. Thank you, Lord, for the prophecies. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to review 2018 prophecies, 2019 prophecies. Truly, you are a God who tells your people ahead of time. You have warned us, yet we are not prepared. Forgive us, O God. Some have prepared for the calamities, and we have informed them. And I thank you, Lord, that you have informed us ahead of time. We're storing food, water, everything. But more than this, God, it's our spiritual. And so, Father, right now, thank you for the encouragement. And I want you, those who are hearing me right now, if you have the gift of tongues, I want you to say and pray it right now. I want you to stir up yourselves in the Spirit. You got to walk in the Spirit every day. And I believe that the power of the tongue is so important. The gift of tongue is so powerful. And I do not know if anyone can move, you know, and just without using the gift of tongue. It's a powerful weapon because it is so good to use it. Because we can immediately connect us to the Spirit of God. The Holy Spirit connects us to the Spirit of God. And I praise you, Holy Spirit, that you have given us the gift of tongues so that we can pray directly to the Father. And your word says, if we do not know what to pray, you will help us pray. And in these last days, God, many of us are tormented. Many are depressed. Many are hungry, oh God, spiritually and even physically, God. Many could not understand what's going on, oh God. But you are Shalom. You are the God of peace. You are the one who gives us peace that surpasses all understanding. The enemy cannot steal our joy. The enemy cannot steal this joy that you have given us. You did not give us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of power. And we have the authority to cast it out in the name of Jesus. And Satan, you and your demons and your demonic plague, we command you out of our household. We command you out of the Philippines. Out of our nation, out of the world, because your time is done in Jesus' name. Your time is finished in Jesus' name. Right now, we will enjoy again, and I'm believing that we will be enjoying the hugs and the kisses of the children of God. No one can stop and hinder our prayers, because you know, and you know you are defeated. You're put in confusion, but your scheme is already exposed. You are exposed in your demons. You are under our feet. You cannot deceive us. We are not double-minded. We are focused on the goals that we have set forth for the body of Christ. We will move. We will go forward in the name of Jesus. We praise the King of Kings. We serve the Most Holy God. We are children of God, and nothing can harm us. And I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We will magnify Jesus. will not magnify you. You are nothing. This virus is nothing in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you are the most powerful God. Thank you, Lord, that you are Jehovah Rapha. You are the healer. You are the healer. And we declare healing right now to those who are sick. We may not be able to lay hands over you, but our God is not limited. Our God is not limited. He transcends everything. He is the most powerful God. He is the Spirit of truth. And His word says that we put our faith in Him. The finished work of Jesus on the cross. Jesus not only triumphed over sin, death, and hell, He also paid for every known sickness and diseases. And thank you, Jesus, that you're more powerful than all of this. Thank you, we receive the healing. We confess, oh Lord, that you are the healer. We confess that we are healed, and confession means possession. We possess this right now in the mighty name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is our barrier, and we are healed inside our bodies and outside. Oh, you were bruised for our iniquities. You were wounded for our transgression. The chastisement upon our body has been paid, and for every stripes, we are healed. Thank you, Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Rapha. Lord, I believe that every time we warfare in the spirit, you send Michael to warfare all these demonic spirits. You send your angel Gabriel to give us messages and strategies. And right now, as we are praying, I know you will send your angel, Raphael. Oh God, because you're Jehovah Rapha and healing. Claim that healing right now. I want you to claim that healing right now for everyone who's sick, for everyone who has the symptoms. Right now, I decree and declare you are healed by the power of the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we serve the one true God. You alone are the healer. You alone are the healer. I feel the presence of God. Thank you, Jesus. You are so powerful. You are so powerful. And I praise
Jesus.
I praise you, Lord. I praise you, Yahweh.
Receive your miracle today. Receive your healing today. The Lord is our healer. The anointing for healing is thick right now. So I believe, so if anyone is sick, just put your hands on the screen right now and receive your healing by the blood of the Lamb. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And if you're praying for someone, you can stand in the gap right now for them. Sickness and disease, you are healed by the blood of the Lamb and by the stripes of Jesus Christ. Receive your healing. He is our healer. He is our healer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Last week, we have started giving out help to the members of River of God that need help financially to be able to feed themselves and help in their income and some gave some groceries that were donated from people from the church. So right now, the second offering will go again to help the members of River of God that need financial help. So today, let's give our offering. We have online giving. So right now, just commit your giving online. And here, Lord, receive our offering. May it be a help to those who need it. Yes, Lord. This is our worship today. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is the first and the greatest commandment. And the second is love your neighbor. Let's give our love to our neighbor. Yes, Lord. Receive it. In Jesus' name we pray. Return it to your people hundredfold. Amen and amen. Raise up your hands to heaven. Father God, right now, every hand raised. Hallelujah. Let heaven touch earth today. May the blessing of the Father be upon you wherever you are. May the protection of the blood of Jesus, Lord, surround every family represented here with your angels, with the fire of the Holy Spirit, by the blood of the Lamb. You are protected in Jesus' name. You are blessed. Amen and amen. God bless you.
Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered.